You are just like Arjuna in the battlefield of life. The mind is very restless, turbulent, strong, and obstinate. O Krishna, it appears to me that it is more difficult to control than the wind. Lord Krishna said, "What you say is correct. The mind is indeed very difficult to restrain, but by practice and detachment, it can be controlled." This is a contemplation and brain rewire video. Here, you are going to learn some perfect lesson to train the mind and also identify the obstacles of your life to obtain peace of mind and success. Please watch carefully. You may be doing any job or business. You may be a seeker in any field. You may be trying hard to control your mind and thoughts, but you are not successful. There is some reason behind it. You must know and act as per that. You are just like Arjuna in the battlefield of life. The mind is very restless, turbulent, strong, and obstinate. O Krishna, it appears to me that it is more difficult to control than the wind. Arjuna describes the troublesome mind. It is restless because it keeps flitting in different directions from subject to subject. It is turbulent because it creates upheavals in one's consciousness in the form of hatred, anger, lust, greed, anxiety, fear, attachment, etc. It is strong because it overpowers the intellect with its vigorous currents and destroys the faculty of discrimination. The mind is also obstinate because it catches a harmful thought. Arjuna declares that the mind is even more difficult to control than the wind. Lord Krishna said, "What you say is correct. The mind is indeed very difficult to restrain, but by practice and detachment, it can be controlled." Sri Krishna responds to Arjuna's comment by calling him Mahabaho, which means mighty armed one. He implies, "O Arjuna, you defeated the bravest warriors in battle. Can you not defeat the mind?" Sri Krishna does not deny the problem by saying, "Arjuna, what nonsense are you speaking? The mind can be controlled very easily." Rather, he agrees with Arjuna's statement that the mind is indeed difficult to control. However, so many things are difficult to achieve in the world, and yet we remain undaunted and move forward. For example, sailors know that the sea is dangerous. The possibility of terrible storms exists, yet they have never found those dangers as sufficient reasons for remaining ashore. Hence, Sri Krishna assures Arjuna that the mind can be controlled by Vairagya and Abhyas. Vairagya means detachment. We observe that the mind runs toward the objects of its attachment, toward the direction it has been habituated to running in the past. The elimination of attachment eradicates the unnecessary wanderings of the mind. Abhyas means practice, or a concerted and persistent effort to change an old habit or develop a new one. Practice is the key that opens the door to mastery and excellence. Take for example typing. The first time people begin typing, they are able to type one word in a minute, but after a year's typing, their fingers fly on the keyboard at the speed of 80 words a minute. This proficiency comes solely through practice. Similarly, the obstinate and turbulent mind has to be made to rest on supreme consciousness. Lord Krishna said to Arjuna, "Those who eat too much or eat too little, sleep too much or too little, cannot attain success in yoga." Sri Krishna states that those who break the rules of bodily maintenance cannot be successful in yoke beginners on the path with their incomplete wisdom state, "You are the soul, not this body." So simply engage in spiritual activity, forgetting about the maintenance of the body. It is wrong. A spiritual seeker must maintain his body to attain success in yoga. Those who are temperate in eating and recreation, balanced in work, and regulated in sleep can mitigate all sorrows by practicing yoga. Yoga is the union of the soul with God. The opposite of yoga is bhog, which means engagement in sensual pleasures, indulgence in bhog, and results in rog, disease. If the body becomes diseased, it impedes the practice of yoga. Thus, in this verse, Sri Krishna states that by being temperate in bodily activities and practicing yoga, we can become free from the sorrows of the body and mind. There is a beautiful story regarding this. It is said that before gaining enlightenment, Gautama Buddha once gave up eating and drinking and sat in meditation. However, after a few days of practicing in this manner, the lack of nourishment made him weak and dizzy, and he found it impossible to steady his mind in meditation. At that time, some village women happened to be passing by. They were carrying water pots on their heads that they had filled from the river nearby and were singing a song. The words of the song were, "Tighten the strings of the tanpura, a stringed Indian musical instrument, but do not tighten them so much that the strings break." Their words entered the ears of Gautama Buddha and he exclaimed, "These illiterate village women are singing such words of wisdom. They contain a message for us humans. We too should tighten our bodies, but not to the extent that the body is destroyed." Benjamin Franklin, a founding father of the United States, is highly regarded as a self-made man. In an effort to grow his character, starting at the age of 20, he maintained a diary in which he tracked his performance related to the 13 activities he wanted to grow in. The first activity was temperance: eat not to dullness, drink not to elevation.